Thank you. That concludes the debate on Scottish Innovation Strategy. It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is a debate on motion 9607 in the name of Liam Kerr on motion of no confidence. I would be grateful if members who wish to speak in the debate were to press their request to speak buttons. And I call on Liam Kerr to speak to and move the motion. Up to 7 minutes, Mr Kerr.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, I've never brought a motion of no confidence in the 7 years I've been in this Parliament, and I hope actually never to do so again. Events of the last 2 years, and particularly the last few weeks, have signalled that the First Minister, in showing his confidence in Lorna Slater, the Minister for Green Skills, Circular Economy and Biodiversity, may be misplaced. And I rise today to offer Parliament the opportunity to state whether it shares the First Minister's confidence. Now, Presiding Officer, I don't know Lorna Slater. Our only major interactions have been in this chamber or in committee. And I do not doubt for a minute her integrity. I do not doubt that she strives to do her best in a crucial and wide-ranging brief. And I do not doubt her commitment to the deposit return scheme. All of those are not in question in my mind, and nor do they fall to be considered today. My reason for bringing this motion is that since being appointed to this crucial ministerial role in autumn 2021, with particular responsibility for implementing Scotland's deposit return scheme, a scheme that all parties in this chamber supported and voted for and wished to see succeed, the Minister has nevertheless struggled. Now, I think Kate Forbes said it best, that the idea of the deposit return scheme is sound. It works well in other countries, but we cannot have a scheme that is well-intentioned but fails to achieve its aims and causes economic carnage in the process. Indeed not. But that failure, that economic carnage, is exactly what we are seeing happening. Whether it be Lorna Slater's first DRS postponement to August 2023, 18 months ago, and then the second postponement to October 2025, just this month. Whether it be knowing for years that an exemption from the Internal Market Act was required, yet only applying for it at the 11th hour. I will.
Ross Greer.
I'm grateful to the member for the intervention. The Conservatives continue pursuing this line that our request for an exemption from the IMA was only requested in March of this year, ignoring the fact that in February this year, sitting on Alistair Jack's desk was a document entitled Full and Final Proposal for the DRS, but also ignoring the fact that nowhere in the common frameworks does it mention the official request for exemption that Alistair Jack only began to speak about in March. So I'm wondering, could Liam Kerr point me towards the point in the common frameworks where it actually says this request mechanism exists?
Liam Kerr. Thank you.
And of course, what we've just heard is the concession that until February, at the earliest, there was no final scheme on which to rule. And Lorna Slater then went on to contradict the scheme administrator, Circularity Scotland, who insisted that DRS was nevertheless very much viable with glass excluded. She chose a further postponement. Did she take legal advice before doing so? Well, she refused to tell me in committee last week, and many have concluded that the answer is no. Whether it was disrespecting the NZEC committee by promising to publish and send a gateway report, then having failed to do so for months, ultimately producing only a summary. I asked what the Scottish Government had budgeted for DRS. Lorna Slater was confused on two occasions and told me what had been spent. Then sent me a letter saying that it was wrapped up in the Zero Waste Scotland budget, then quoted in that letter the wrong budget figures for the last 3 years. Whether it be knowing what would happen to the fines from the deposit return scheme, whether it be failing to warn Circularity Scotland bosses of the delay to the deposit return scheme in advance, then telling the committee, the Net Zero Committee last week, that it was fully capitalised and there wasn't a problem with funding. Yeah. Albeit, she also told the committee last week that she didn't know the nature of that funding, a statement that was reiterated earlier today. And all that just a week before today's bombshell that CSL has entered administration and around 60 people are looking for work. These are people who trusted the minister to speak for them in government, to command the respect of this House and answer truthfully and fully and take a collaborative approach. And businesses who have forked out hundreds of millions of pounds now face a scheme that's entirely up in the air, and the position on compensation is entirely unclear. And that's just the DRS side of the portfolio. Members will well remember Lorna Slater admitting to using a misleading renewable statistics, then not only failing to correct the record, but walking out of the chamber as I made a point of order to try and specifically highlight that. And the private charter boat to visit Rum, rather than using the public ferry at a cost of £1,200 against less than £10. Or having an empty limousine driven from the central belt to the northeast to pick her up and drive her back to Edinburgh. Indeed, she's used the chauffeur-driven car for 50 journeys in the last year, despite urging Scots to use public transport instead of private vehicles. And then she confessed in November 22 that she didn't know the difference between the Scottish Parliament and the Scottish Government, whilst believing...
Excuse me, Mr Kerr. Members, can I ask that we treat one another with courtesy and respect? Excuse me, members, we may at times disagree with what is being said. That does not mean that we continue to have conversations or make sedentary contributions. Mr Kerr.
Whilst she also believes that economic growth is wrong, leading Fergus Ewing to describe her as the enemy of Scotland's small businesses. Presiding officer, these are significant errors of judgment in a portfolio which we all want, no, need to succeed. So, presiding officer, in conclusion, I said at the start, and I remind the chamber, this is not a question of Lorna Slater's integrity. It is not a question of whether one supports or opposes the Bute House Agreement. It is not a question of whether a member agrees with the principle of a deposit return scheme. The only question that is relevant is whether a member believes that Lorna Slater retains their confidence to carry out the duties, responsibilities and functions of the Minister for Green Skills, Circular Economy and Biodiversity. If she does, they will vote against my motion and signal that they believe she retains their confidence. If she does not, they will vote for the motion that they do not have confidence in Lorna Slater to continue as the Minister. In order that Parliament has that opportunity to speak, I move the motion in my name.
Thank you. I now call on Hamza Youssef, up to 6 minutes, First Minister.
Presiding Officer, Lorna Slater and I are, of course, members of different parties, different traditions even, but we have chosen, for the good of our country, the good of our climate, to find compromise and indeed to work together in the national interest. We've seen time and time again members on other sides of the chamber call for action that will tackle the climate emergency, only, of course, to time and time again shirk their responsibilities when difficult decisions need to be made. Lorna Slater does not do that. She does not shirk her responsibilities. Today, again, we see the Conservatives engage in tactics which are, let's be honest, aimed to deflect rather than engage on the serious issues our country faces. Today, we regrettably learn that a process is underway to appoint administrators to Circularity Scotland. This is not a result of the Scottish Government's actions. It's not a result of Lorna Slater's actions. Responsibility lies solely and squarely with a Conservative UK government whose aim it has been from the very beginning to sabotage this DRS scheme. Liam Kerr, in his contribution, said, rightly of course, that this Parliament voted for a deposit return scheme, that they voted for the regulations. The only small bit that he missed out, of course, was that they agreed to a scheme which included glass within that scheme. And what do we have? A Conservative administration who at the 11th hour torpedoed Scotland's deposit return scheme, making it impossible to progress. Actions taken in the absolute full knowledge of the consequences that this would have for Scottish businesses and indeed for the scheme and Circularity Scotland. It's therefore extraordinary that the Scottish Conservatives are now tabling a vote of no confidence in the Minister for Green Skills, the Circular Economy and Biodiversity, despite her unwavering commitment to our deposit return scheme, something mentioned by Liam Kerr in his own contribution. It's hardly a surprise that the people of Scotland, quite frankly, have given the Tories a vote of no confidence in every election in the last 50 years, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer,
thank you.
Let me be clear. It is the Conservatives that have destroyed Scottish jobs and investment. It's the Tories who have undermined devolution at every single turn. It is the Conservatives, in bringing this absurd motion, who are showing themselves completely unable to take responsibility for the catastrophic decisions of their UK counterparts. On DRS, with the wrecking, I will end shortly, on DRS, it is the wrecking actions of Alistair Jagg that have put this scheme into jeopardy. What is Lorna Slater expected? Is she expected to be a mind reader? What will the deposit that the UK government will compel us to charge? They haven't told us what that deposit would be, and they expect alignment. They expect alignment when they haven't told us what the registration fee will be. They expect alignment when they haven't told us what has to be on the labels. Can any Conservative member tell us what will be in a UK deposit return scheme? I'll give way to Jamie Halker-Johnson.
Jamie Halker-Johnson.
I thank the First Minister for taking the intervention. Can I ask him, given he's been in the meetings with businesses, he's seen the anger, the frustration, he knows the amount of money that's been spent by businesses with this scheme, and he says that
Mr. Halker-Johnson, can Mr. Halker-Johnson please have silence while he puts his question?
He said that Lorna Slater takes responsibility for the role that she's played. At any time has she offered her resignation?
First Minister.
That wasn't worth the wait, but interestingly, Jamie Halker-Johnson, of course, was unable to give me a single answer to any of the questions that I posed. And of course,
thank you, members.
I have been in meetings with Lorna Slater, proud to be in meetings with Lorna Slater, where she has engaged with hundreds of businesses. And of course, it is a number of iconic Scottish businesses and brands who have told us that the UK government's interventions would put them at a competitive disadvantage. This Parliament, Presiding Officer, was set up to serve the people in Scotland, to encourage collaboration between parties, to deliver a better, fairer Scotland. I'm proud to be part of a government that embodies those values by bringing Green ministers into the Scottish Government for the first time anywhere here, or indeed anywhere in government in the UK. The question I have is, are Labour and the Liberal Democrats going to blindly follow the Conservative whip here and continue to give them protection, give them cover, to continue to undermine our democratic parliament? I would hope not, but we will see very, very shortly. Instead of working to deliver a better Scotland, the Conservatives are doing what their colleagues in Westminster are telling them to do. By contrast, we have Lorna Slater, who works every day to serve the people of Scotland. She's delivering great progress in efforts to tackle the nature emergency. She's been overseeing the development of our new biodiversity strategy, the establishment of our new £65 million Nature Restoration Fund. Under Lorna Slater's leadership on the circular economy, we've made one of the biggest investments in a generation to modernise recycling in Scotland through the £70 million Recycling Improvement Fund. Presiding Officer, I'll conclude by saying that the Tories have spent many months trying to undermine the operations of this Parliament. Hardly a surprise, of course, from the party who opposed the creation of this Parliament in the first place. So let's face it, it's no coincidence they have pressed this stunt just a day after the House of Commons voted to press sanctions on Boris Johnson, sanctions that the soon-to-be Lord Jack failed to support. So today, we know, is meant to be a distraction from the work this government is undertaking, the work that Lorna Slater is undertaking to improve our nation. I encourage members to flatly reject this Conservative motion and stand up for this Scottish Parliament and Scotland's devolution.
Thank you. I now call on Sarah Boyack. Up to 4 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I am personally no stranger to motions of no confidence, having been the second minister to face a motion of no confidence. But until Recently, Presiding Officer, there was another course of action that could have been taken. On the 19th of April, I wrote to the First Minister outlining my concerns on the Minister's ability to help reset the Scottish Government's relationship with business and deliver a workable DRS that commanded the confidence of producers, industry and consumers. At that time, my solution was removing ministerial responsibility for the DRS from Lorna Slater, a solution that was sensible and would have helped reset that relationship with business and get us a scheme in place. I've actually still received no official reply, but I do know the First Minister's spokesperson said that the First Minister had full confidence in Lorna Slater. I do accept that Lorna Slater is not the only minister at fault. After all, it was the SNP's Rosanna Cunningham that pushed ahead with the legislation, and it has been championed heavily by First Ministers. But Lorna Slater was in charge of the scheme and is responsible for the mess we have now. This is difficult to listen to, but I have a short period. The Minister failed to listen to businesses and stakeholders. Stakeholders such as GS1 UK and British Glass, who told me they were not given meetings with the Minister despite repeated requests. And local businesses did not get meetings with the Minister until MSPs asked for those meetings. Leaving local authorities in the dark also happened, not seeing them as potential partners, leaving them unable to prepare for the financial impact on their waste services. And the Scottish Government failed to request a DRS IMA exclusion request for 6 months. But last week at the Net Zero Committee, Lorna Slater washed her hands of all responsibility for the work of the CSL. Despite questions from MSPs on viability,
Excuse me, Ms Boyack, can I ask that all the conversations that are going on over the aisles cease? Ms Boyack.
She said that these were matters for industry. And in response to my topical question today, we learned that CSL has called in the administrators. I've stated previously that the Tory government's actions are indefensible, but the Scottish Government must also be held accountable for the decisions they've made. And, Presiding Officer, last week I discovered through an FOI that in February this year there were concerns over the viability of the August 23 go-live date. The Scottish Government's Director of Environment and Forestry emailed officials in DEFRA saying, can we please meet urgently to what can be done to deliver a fast-track commitment to an IMA exemption within the next week. If it lingers beyond then, we run a risk, very serious risk, of compromising our 16th August go-live date. Now, in February, Lorna Slater and Nicola Sturgeon toured TV and radio studios encouraging businesses to part with their cash and sign up for the scheme. And in this chamber, at the end of February, the Minister said Scotland's deposit return scheme remains on course to launch on 16th of August this year. So while the Minister painted a rosy picture for MSPs, her officials were warning that there was a very serious risk that the August 2023 go-live date wouldn't work. So businesses have invested hundreds of millions of pounds in a scheme that in private ministers knew was likely to be delayed, but Lorna Slater and Nicola Sturgeon left Scottish businesses in the dark. Then we'd the delay till March next year. Scottish businesses have been under immense financial stress and pressures. And the First Minister himself mentioned that hundreds of millions of pounds of investment has been made, but it will not now be used. We've had months of chaos and grandstanding. This SNP Green government has now failed to deliver on reuse, recycling, tackling litter, and somebody must be held accountable. Presiding Officer, 2 months ago, I asked Humza Yousaf to take responsibility and remove Lorna Slater of ministerial responsibility for the DRS. At the end of the day, it is not fair for workers to lose their jobs as a result of government decisions and for Lorna Slater not to lose hers.
Thank you. I now call on Mark Ruskell.
Thanks very much, Presiding Officer. Well, this motion of no confidence is the most shameless, cynical and desperate stunt by the Tories that I've seen yet in this chamber. And on the very day that their leadership fell apart at Westminster, amongst the lies of Boris Johnson, they lodged this motion in a pathetic attempt to distract everyone from the dying days of their government. And the audacity of this motion, the absolute brass neck of it, beggars belief. Because it was the Tories who scuppered the DRS scheme, They forced the removal of glass, which the scheme was built around, and they set the conditions on its operation that are impossible to plan for. And now they're trying to gaslight Scotland into believing it was somehow Lorna Slater's fault all along. It is absurd, Presiding Officer. Now, we can expect this kind of rank opportunism from the Tories.
Absolutely.
But what about Labour? I urge every Labour and Liberal Democrat MSP in this chamber to think long and hard about what they're voting for and who they're lining up with to do it. For this is not just an attack on Lorna Slater. It's an attack on everyone who believes in devolution.
Thank you.
Sarah, if Sarah Boyack, she's shaking her head, if Sarah Boyack doesn't believe me, then listen to Welsh First Minister Mark Drakeford, who recognises this power grab for exactly what it is. Now, Presiding Officer, it is important to reflect on the qualities which good ministers have in abundance. The ability to show determination is important, but so is the ability to listen, to understand how policy affects people and business, and to respond with humility to concerns with improvements. Now, Lorna Slater has been tasked by this Parliament with bringing in one of the most ambitious DRS schemes in Europe. She spent the last 18 months listening, responding, and revising the scheme. And we now have a DRS that has been designed and shaped by business itself. It sets the model for the UK. And Lorna Slater deserves huge credit for getting it to the point of launch,
Mr. Ruskell, if you could just... I'm finding it very difficult to hear Mr. Ruskell. I'd be grateful if we could hear Mr. Ruskell. Please refrain from commenting. Mr. Ruskell.
We can contrast the actions of Lorna Slater with the disgraceful actions of Alistair Jack, who, as Secretary of State, stood up in the House of Commons and completely misrepresented our deposit return scheme. Alistair Jack and his fellow ministers have acted with disdain for Scottish business, contempt for the years of work to design and invest in a DRS scheme for Scotland. They have not listened, they have not compromised, and refuse even now to provide the certainty that business needs to go forward. And last night, Jack wouldn't even vote to censure Boris Johnson for breaking almost every rule in the book. Instead, he stood right with him to the shameful end. If anyone should be resigning, it is him.
Thank you.
Now, I'm proud of my minister, Lorna Slater. She's not only brought DRS to the point of launch, she's increased investment in nature, she's banned new waste incinerators, she's brought forward a circular economy bill to cut littering and waste, and she's delivering Scotland's first new national park in a generation. She's a doer, a renewables engineer with real-world experience in industry. We are lucky to have her. And yet the disrespect and lack of courtesy, even now shown by some members in this chamber, has at times disgusted me. This Parliament needs more Lorna Slaters, and so does this government. So get used to her, because she's just getting started and has barely even begun to deliver the transformative agenda of the Greens in government. She's not going anywhere but forward tonight.
Thank you. I now call on Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, I take no pleasure in addressing the Chamber on the matter before us. My party will vote for the motion tonight because we believe that the situation is just too far gone for Lorna Slater to retain the confidence of this Parliament. That's because it is clear that business lost confidence in this minister a long time ago. There was immense frustration at her failure to answer basic questions about such an important scheme. There was immense frustration at a scheme design that was going to take Scottish produce off Scottish shelves. If it had been executed with care from the start, like in other European countries, it could have dramatically reduced waste and emissions. Instead, a pig's ear was made of a good idea, and no amount of spin can hide that. Retailers and producers could have worked with a scheme that was coherent and didn't throw up barriers, but that's not what this SNP Green government put in front of them. Businesses have been caught in the middle, strung along, incurring costs and desperately struggling to navigate the uncertainty. Staff at Circularity Scotland, that's 60 people, have been left high and dry and facing immediate unemployment. For months, there has been cross-party pressure, including from government backbenchers, for the Scottish Government to amend the deposit return scheme. We offered good and reasoned debate about why delays and changes were necessary. But I have to say, Presiding Officer, if the Conservatives were serious about this vote today, they would have talked to those other MSPs and parties beforehand. They did not. Instead, I believe there is an element of deflection from the Conservatives here, an attempt to distract from
Let's
their
hear
own...
Mr Cole Hamilton.
An attempt, certainly, to distract... An attempt, certainly, to distract from their own problems in London, and it is not a coincidence that this no-confidence vote is what Conservative MSPs were tweeting about last night while MPs backed the Partygate report. So, in my party, we find this debate wholly depressing, because the problem at the heart of all of this, is that we have two governments that are both incapable of owning up to their mistakes, that deflect blame, and for whom cooperation is a dirty word. Even if that is what hard... I'm sorry, I'm coming, closing my remarks. I'm afraid. Even if that is what hard-pressed businesses are crying out for. Business did lose confidence in Lorna Slater long ago, but they wouldn't have much good to say about either of our governments, if we're honest. We are listening to them, and it is in that context that Scottish Liberal Democrats will be voting for this motion tonight.
Thank you. I call on Rachel Hamilton to wind up.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Today's vote of no confidence is not a matter anyone would take lightly, but I want to make it clear to Ms Slater that this is not personal. This is about a collective failure in the Minister and indeed her government's ability to deliver on the promises they made to Scotland. Lorna Slater, a Green Skills, the Circular Economy and Biodiversity Minister who travelled to the Western Isles on a chartered catamaran at public expense, pleaded ignorance in the face of questioning around gene editing to the UK Minister, a Minister that failed to warn of the delays to DRS. The SNP knew what was on the horizon, Presiding Officer. Wildlife management, a fishing ban on 50% of Scotland's seas, and they saw their scapegoat for the inevitable calamities that would follow. She was thrown to the wolves, and the wolves have had a field day. Fergus Ewing described Ms Slater as the enemy of small businesses. With Ms Slater in post, Scotland's carbon emissions increased. Biodiversity has plummeted, with iconic species such as the capercaillie on the brink of extinction, and the Minister has failed to make any progress on her plans to ban waste incineration. A King Midas in reverse, everything that Ms Slater has touched has seemed to turn to screeching U-turns, lengthy delays and anything but gold. Yeah. But one thing I would say is that her failures do not need to be a bad thing. We can learn from these mistakes. We can begin to understand the value of proper consultation, of taking our time to get things right, of evidence-based policy making that engages and listens to businesses and communities right throughout the process. Ideological fervour alone is never enough. It falls short of the expectations of the Scottish public, which they all have in us. And that, I feel, goes to the heart of what has gone wrong here. Rushing policies like the deposit return scheme and the fishing ban without taking the time to speak to those whose lives will be most affected by this comes at a cost. The cost is the trust of the people, and the cost is the trust in this government's ability to do the right thing. Presiding Officer, we cannot ignore the Minister's woeful record on maintaining the trust of the people in Scotland. As Blair Bowman said of her handling of DRS, we deserve better than this incompetence. Can the public continue to trust a minister who misled Parliament over Scotland's renewable energy statistics? Can business trust a minister who doesn't believe in the concept of economic growth? Can farmers trust a minister who repeatedly ignored formal and informal warnings over the need to allow the use of Azulox? And most importantly, can we trust a minister who promised to deliver a deposit return scheme which has put the firm in charge of the scheme under threat of bankruptcy? jeopardising jobs and investment.
Members.
Presiding officer, the answer, I'm afraid, is no.
That concludes the debate on motion of no confidence. It's now time to move on to the next item of business. And there are four questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that Amendment 9594.2, in the name of Jamie Halcrow-Johnston, which seeks to amend motion 9594 in the name of Richard Lockhead on Scottish Innovation Strategy, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.